Having arrested its descent down the Formula One grid with an impressive 2019 season, McLaren begins 2020 with renewed vigour and a refreshed paint scheme to kick off the new year. Conforming to F1's current trends and daubing its MCL35 with a matte papaya finish, McLaren has also upped the amount of blue areas adorning its reworked livery. But you're not here for colour theory lessons. One element that has emerged as part of an ever-growing trend this season is the thin, tapered nose section. First pioneered by Mercedes, McLaren adopted a similar design in 2018, but the nose has been tightened up even more for 2020, with a far less cluttered arrangement around the crash structure. In the previous 2 years, this was home to a central snorkel and two surrounding nostrils, but McLaren has elected to discard these. The front wing seems distinctly similar to, if not the same as, last year's design, and perhaps there's more to come from McLaren in that area. It's expected that the team will retain the same inboard-loaded philosophy that it successfully transitioned to last year. On the suspension, McLaren has pulled a design out of its back catalogue, and the top wishbone is mounted to an extended horn attached to the upright, which was first explored last year in practice at Spa. Another area distinctly similar to last year's car lies in the bargeboard geometry. Opting to show 2019 parts in the front wing and bargeboard areas suggests that McLaren is holding a little something back from its launch package. Although McLaren placed some of its cooling components below the engine cover last year, it appears as though a few more parts have been pulled out of the side pod area and placed above the intake in the MCL35. The side pods are, as a result, even tighter than last year's specification, while the engine cover is just a little bit larger. The air intake has lost its oval shape and instead looks a little more free-form, where each of the divisions used will be used for different things, for example cooling and the engine and compressor intake. There's not a great deal of difference at the rear wing, with the end plates in a similar form to last year's final designs. The car has been launched without a distinct gurney flap or any kind of T-wing geometry, but those are all flexible changes that can be added from round to round. If the MCL35 emerges as an even quicker prospect than last season, then Carlos Sainz and Lando Norris will be adequately equipped to pick up regular points and the occasional podium. Firstly, McLaren must prove that the recent bad years were an exception, not the rule. 2019 was its highest watermark in years, and while the team must be ambitious enough to want more, it must also be mindful that it cannot mount a sustained challenge to Formula One's Big Three. At least, not at this stage.